Sri Lanka's first coal power plant was established in Norochcholai in 2011 with a generator capacity of 300 megawatts. Two more generator units were added in 2014. These units have yard scrubbing units, and its environmental impact assessments anticipated that the emitted air quality will be within acceptable limit. However, these plants have been malfunctioning frequently. The villagers and plant personnel complain of difficulties in breathing and of soot depositing on vegetation, houses and the environment. In Sri Lanka, the quality of air has deteriorated in recent decades due to pollution from traffic, industries, agricultural and forest fires. Air pollutants can cause respiratory and other health problems among people, animals, food production, water quality and the ecosystem. In Sri Lanka, there has not been readily available air quality measurements to alert people to the risks until 2017. For our work, we visited the coal power plant and met with the technical staff, studied the planning, environmental impacts assessment and monitoring reports of the coal power plant, met with local residents, farmers and fishermen, undertook a program to continuously monitor particulates in the air in the vicinity of the coal power plant. We studied the air quality in Navalapitiya, which is a location with pristine air in the Tea Highlands, Norochcholai, which has a coal power plant, Kalamasovan, which has industrial and traffic pollution. While particulates are only one aspect of air pollution, it is amenable to easier monitoring and tracking, and we can infer implications for the other aspects. The harmful components of air pollution include particulates, nitrous and sulfurous oxides, volatile organic compounds and non-organic compounds. Now it is possible to continuously monitor in real time the particulates as fine as 2.5 microns that can lodge in the lungs. This is referred to as PM2.5. We chose previously well-tested instruments from Yar Visual and Purple Yar companies. Before we used these instruments, we calibrated them with a higher quality device, that is certified BAM device, to decide whether our measurements are reliable or not. We found that both Purple Yar and Yar Visual compare adequately in terms of magnitude and variations. We installed these instruments in Norochcholai, Navalapitiya and Colombo. Observations are recorded every few minutes. Using these data, we analyze the transportation of particulates from coal power plant. In Norochcholai, PM2.5 data from March to April 2018, we can identify three key time periods in relation to the plant emissions. Phase 1, the electrostatic precipitator ESP, that is the air scrubbing unit of plant 1, worked with low effectiveness. Phase 2, the unit 1 was shut down. Phase 3, unit 1 was repaired and worked with improved effectiveness. The pollution levels for the first period is much higher than the other two time periods. The lowest PM2.5 measurements were recorded during shutdown period. If we draw an envelope of the measurements for the shape of the bar charts for Norochcholai, Navalapitiya and for Colombo PM2.5 levels, then it shows that Colombo and Navalapitiya follow a similar envelope as Norochcholai. There are differences due to other meteorological factors, but this gives an indication that coal power plants might have an influence on these locations' air quality. Detailed statistical analysis confirms this, and we have reported these findings to scientists. It's useful to study the hourly average of PM2.5 levels in Colombo for March and April. There is a peak in the morning around 7 a.m. and 8 a.m. corresponding to school and office traffic. In Navalapitiya, the peak is around 5 p.m. and 6 p.m. This time gap between the Colombo and Navalapitiya peaks suggests a component of pollution could be transported by prevailing wind from western side to central highlands. We have provided some interpolated maps showing a rough assessment of regional spread for March and April 2018. The darker the color, the more pollutants in that area. Air quality as of April was better than in March. Throughout March, the coal power plant's ESP unit did not work optimally, so likely causes higher PM2.5 levels of March. We obtained wind measurements taken by FECT and other organizations in this area. For example, the wind direction data in Kurunagala for March and April. The wind direction goes through a reversal in this period associated with the trade winds, almost reversed. In both months, there is a small but significant fraction of time when the air blows from Putlam to the western hills. Now, with the weather stations, data analysis for reliability and scale, and online monitoring, we soon hope to give alerts of air quality and to study furthermore.